Hey everyone, I'm coming to you from my office at work today on my lunch break. And today I'm talking to you about the Kronos 3K raw carbon fiber paddle from AMA Sport. Let's talk about the specs and then I'll talk to you about my thoughts on this paddle. So the Kronos raw 3K has a 16 millimeter core with a 3K raw carbon fiber surface. It weighs in at about 7.9 to 8.4 ounces. Mine came in at 8.2 ounces. We're going to talk about that weight a little bit more later on. It's about 16.3 inches long and about 7.4 inches wide. It's got a 5.7 inch long handle, so nice long handle, and a 4.25 inch circumference. The grip has got this perforated type grip, and it's also quite tacky as well. So again, we'll talk about that a little bit more later on. So let's talk about the pop power of this paddle. When I was playing, I didn't really feel like the ball was popping off the face of the paddle a lot, which is, you know, a lot of raw carbon fiber paddles, they have that problem. I think the core is soft enough to prevent that from happening. The paddle is a bit head heavy, and so that gives you tons of power for putaways and for drives. In addition, I was able to use that power on my serves as well, so came in very handy there. So as far as spin and control are concerned, I could generate good spin with the paddle, and I was able to maintain good dink rallies with the paddle, as well as drops from the baseline and mid-court were pretty routine with this paddle. That was one thing, you know, when you don't have the pop and you got a little bit more dwell time of the ball on the paddle, those dink rallies and those thirds are really going to improve. So now the weight and the speed of this paddle. Now, this paddle weighs 0.4 ounces, so almost half an ounce less than my Vatic Pro, but it feels heavier because of how the weight is distributed. The weight is a lot more towards the head of the paddle, and so that makes it feel a lot heavier and a little bit slower in the hand than some of the other paddles that I've played with. However, it is solid on resets because of that head-heavy balance. It didn't twist much in my hand. The sweet spot seemed to be pretty large and pretty wide on the paddle, which don't see some, you know, sometimes you don't see that a lot in paddles. And both my son and I, he commented as well. He played with this as well. He's probably 4.25, where I'm like a 3.5. He noted that, and I noted too, that one-handed backhands were a lot slower. He said he had a lot of trouble getting this thing around for a one-handed backhand. So you're going to want to use that elongated handle to do some two-handed backhands with this paddle. All right, so let's talk about the grip and the appearance. So when I first saw a picture of this paddle, I immediately thought of the Yola Perseus. I will say, however, I do like the color. I like the edge guard color, and I like the color of the grip. The grip is nice and tacky. It stays put in my hand. And because the handle's elongated, it's really good for two-handed backhands. And I guess eventually I'll develop a two-handed forehand. We'll see. Maybe. We'll give it a try. And because of that weight distribution that I mentioned earlier, the elongated handle really is needed for those backhands so you can get that two-handed backhand in. Okay, so let's talk price and value. So this generally sells for $150 on Amazon. And as of this recording, there's a $30 off coupon that you can get, brings it down to $120. But if you use the code 10DNPK02, should be on the screen right now, that will bring the price down, get you another 10% off, and bring the price down to around $105. And that is an excellent value for a paddle like this. I'm really impressed with the workmanship of this paddle and the way that it plays. So $105 for a paddle like this that, as far as I can tell, plays pretty similar to a Perseus. I haven't played with the Perseus very much, but I have swung one around a little bit. Seems like a no-brainer if you're looking to move from one of those more inexpensive brands to a more premium brand. All right, so that gets me to, who is this for? Well, I think it's for the recreational player that may be looking to get into some tournaments and maybe move up and improve their gameplay, who want a premium paddle, but they don't want to pay a premium price. Now, this isn't any kind of long-term review, so I don't know how long the paddle is going to hold up, but as you can see by some of the B-roll footage, I did have some fun with the paddle because I couldn't get any footage of me playing with the paddle. But, it's no worse for wear for the paddle. They throw in a number of additional kind of perks and values. It's got a really nice cover like here. You know, it's like this pleather. And they even included a paddle eraser, which I haven't had need to use yet because, I've been playing indoor pickleball mostly. And I don't know about the rest of you, but I found that the indoor balls don't shed as much material onto a carbon fiber paddle as the outdoor ones. Let me know in the comments if you think that. So I want to thank AMA Sport for sending me this paddle. Remember, there's that additional 10% off using the code 10DNPK02. If you go over to Amazon and get that, there'll be a link in the description and in the pinned comment for this video. I think this is a great all-around paddle that leans more towards power. You've got some control with it. You've got the put-away power with it, but it doesn't have that crazy pop like you've seen with some other raw carbon fiber paddles. So, till next time, my name is John. Thanks for watching, and keep dinking.